It was Christmas time. Dr. Watson visited his old friend Sherlock Holmes at 221B Baker Street in London. Watson found Holmes still wearing his dressing gown and engrossed in the examination of a battered hat with his magnifying glass. Sherlock Holmes told Dr. Watson that Peterson, the security guard, had given him a hat and a goose. Peterson found these two things when he was coming home at about 4 o'clock on Christmas morning after attending a party. He saw a tall man carrying a goose over his shoulders. Suddenly, a group of rough young men attacked the tall man. One of the young men knocked the tall man's hat off. He raised his stick to defend himself and accidentally smashed the shop behind him. Peterson came forward to protect the tall man from his attackers. The tall man thought Peterson was a policeman, so he dropped the goose and ran away. The young man also ran away. Peterson then picked up the hat and goose and brought them to Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes had kept the hat and given the goose to Peterson for his wife to cook. A card attached to the bird was addressed to Mrs. Henry Baker, and the initials HB were imprinted on the hat, suggesting it belonged to Mr. Henry Baker. From the size and appearance of the hat, Holmes deduced that Henry Baker was an intelligent man, was less well off than he had been earlier, and a man of self-respect. At this point, Peterson returned to tell them that during the preparation for cooking, Mrs. Peterson had found a blue diamond in the stomach of the goose. The blue diamond was the blue carbuncle, a precious stone that was stolen from the room of Hotel Cosmopolitan. It belonged to Countess Morcar. The blue carbuncle was stolen on 22nd December. John Horner, a plumber, was accused of stealing it. James Wider, an employee at the hotel, had called up the police and said that he had shown Horner the room of Countess of Morcar for some repair work. As he had some work in hand, he left the room, and when he returned, Horner had disappeared and the diamond had been stolen. Hence, John Horner was arrested. Sherlock Holmes placed an advertisement in the evening papers so that Henry Baker could come and collect his things from Baker Street. Henry Baker turned up and took his things. He was completely unaware of the blue carbuncle. In fact, he was more worried about the goose. So, Holmes gave him a fresh one. Henry Baker then told Sherlock Holmes that he had bought the goose at the Alpha Inn. Holmes and Watson set out to find about the blue carbuncle. They went to the local inn where Henry Baker had bought the goose. They found out that the goose had been bought from a salesman called Breckenridge in Covent Garden. So, Holmes and Watson went to Covent Garden Market to get some information from Breckenridge. Breckenridge told them he had bought the goose from Mrs. Oakshott, a poultry and egg purveyor in Britain. After Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson had walked some distance away from Covent Garden Market, they heard angry voices from the stall they had left. Turning round, they saw Breckenridge arguing with a man. Suddenly, the man turned, ran off down the dark street. Holmes and Watson followed the man and soon caught up with him. The man told them that his name was James Wider. Holmes then asked James Wider to accompany him to Baker Street. Holmes then told him about the goose and the blue carbuncle that came out of it. James Wider confessed his crime and told the whole story. Wider had come to know about the blue carbuncle from Catherine Cusack, the maid of the Countess of Morcar. Wider had stolen the diamond and wanted to leave no track of being the thief. So, he framed John Horner. After stealing the diamond, James Wider went straight away to Mrs. Oakshott's farm. Mrs. Oakshott was his sister. She reared geese for the market. Wider had an idea. He caught one goose and thrust a diamond down its throat. Meanwhile, his sister came, and as he turned to speak to her, the goose mixed among the other geese. His sister told him to choose a goose. Now Ryder chose the one which he thought had the diamond. When he took the goose home and cut it, he did not find the diamond. He hurried back to his sister's farm, but she had sold all the geese to Breckenridge of Covent Garden. Now Ryder fell on his knees in front of Holmes, begging for mercy. He told him he had never ever committed any crime. He pleaded to be pardoned. Holmes listened to him and allowed Ryder to leave. Holmes explained to Watson that he was not there to do the work of the police. He also believed that Ryder had been very frightened and shaken up. Without the testimony of John Ryder, the case against James Horner also collapsed and he was freed.